So I want to get in a bunch of pieces of my time slot, so I'm going to just take them back to back. Once upon a time, there was a little girl who lived in a beautiful but dangerous world. There were trees that rained fruit, birds that danced cod and coo, and a monkey who liked to visit and send the little girl butterfly kisses. Though at dark times many stars shone bright, no one dared leave their home at night for fear of what else might fly in the sky. Bangs, bursts, and blasts from a neighboring town kept people's faces painted with frown. Then, on one more schoolless day, the little girl's amma said, "Maha, we cannot stay, or people with guns will take you away." As the little girl packed, she felt sadness grow. The monkey spied scheming and jumped in with her clothes. The little girl squealed from sob into laugh, put finger to lips and closed up the bag. The little girl, her amma and monkey hiding, got in a boat leaving early next morning. Salt water rose, rippled and curved, carrying them towards a different new world. As another coast neared, the boat came to a stall. The little girl awoke, hearing her amma bawl. "We're too far from the beach, it's still out of our reach. How can I swim with my child and my things?" The boatman pushed them onto a mound of sand with only room for little girl and amma to stand. The monkey escaped from his hiding place to see water leaping high, warning each side that the mound would vanish with the coming tide. The hot air wrinkled, the ocean curled. Amma prayed as she held her last living girl. As they huddled close, the little girl began to cry, and the monkey hid under the fall of Amma's sari to hide. When suddenly, the little girl had an idea to try, and her Amma had seemed to have read her mind. They unraveled the sari to sway in the air, jumped up and down, let their voices blare. The monkey shrieked, they waved, they screamed over ocean's curls and crashing sounds. We must escape this shrinking mound. They conjured all their power and were finally found. Years later, the little girl will remember her strike, knowing no matter the danger, she can survive. When others plot against her dignity, she will speak the story of how she faced the vigor of the sea with her amma and monkey to become a refugee. Her father was born with an opening at the top of his mouth, a cleft palate, a hole in need of mending. His parents sought healing, took the boy to the doctors, but at the hospital, he caught polio, which mangled his legs, and the hole was still there. People fear mangled legs and strange walks. Perhaps the disease they talk are punished for past crimes, and people think that twisted bones are twisted minds. But intelligent children treated like imbeciles become angry and fistful, fury volatile as a pistol. Metal calipers meant to fix a cripple bound the young boy ankle to knee. His dream becoming to walk free. Until then, when threatened, he used them as weapons. He cracked and bloodied skulls, sending others to hospitals. He threw bricks through windows, teachers tied him to chairs, and his anger grew. More surgeries, over another year trapped within infirmaries. His grandmother was his only school. She told him stories of Tamil soldiers fighting for the British in World War II, coming back with chopped limbs, and his anger grew. Every day she read him the newspaper. He had nothing to do but think. Then came Sinhala-only acts, more gatherings, tear gas, more lies, torture, propaganda, and his anger grew. His dream becoming for his people to walk free. He gave speeches, a wall should be built between Tamil and Sinhala. He placed rage and brilliance in the troubles. At 14, he was a part of a movement, a part of standing tall against all those who exploit us. That burning, empty buildings would lead to a land full of mines. Children clutching machine guns, cyanide capsules around necks, the massacre of neighbors who pray in your own tongue, thousands and thousands pushed from home. He didn't know that liberation could become a prison, destroying everything you have ever known to be precious. Revolutions of power, burning and turning. Revolutions of power, burning and turning. You've got to love your people to serve your people. You've got to love your people to defend your people. You've got to love your people to protect your people. Who will love our people? Who will love our people? Her father couldn't run, but he rode all of Jaffna, Yalpan, by bicycle. Now Jaffna is full of hope. Made by those who took up arms, but caught a disease that mangled their hearts. The people search for healing, but the holes are still there. Safety zone. Lush rains, trees where the road flooded with the people seeking safety was shelled. Lush rains, trees where the road flooded with the people seeking safety was shelled. The thick air and muddied red soil is unable to swallow the mounting bodies or muffle her scream as a woman is herded into a camp, split from her dying husband, trapped in a small room with 30 more cries, fed food that pours out of her faster than the tears. She bathes under army men's open eyes, unable to leave. No visitations, guarded from dignity, imprisoned in safety. Lush rains, trees, where the road flooded with the people seeking safety was shed. A baby is cradled between craters left by airstrikes the government says they never launched. A young girl tries to fill infant ears with her strange song. Feed the child something other than the smell of decaying flesh. This should not be the scent of first breath. To survive, an elder buries herself with only her face uncovered, the earth her only shield against the shells that may fall as she tries to rest. The injured strip and tear clothing to dress exposed tissue and bone, press sand into rancid wounds. This, they say, is the end of terror. This, they say, is the end of war. This, they say, is victory. In desperation, the cruel become even crueler, the monstrous more monstrous, and each uses the other's evil to justify their own. Lush rains, trees, where the road flooded with the people seeking safety was
The next is actually a medley. I'm trying to squeeze in as much as I can. It's a medley of four different pieces. So it's just going to be little excerpts from four different pieces. Now folks don't even blink at butter and firefly. But back then in the day, not one thought it right, with butterfly being of the day and firefly of the night. Who ever heard of a lightning bug and a butterfly getting together? I don't even know how they do it. Jamming together mismatched puzzle pieces. It's disgusting.
But to them, they fit precise. Butterfly being of color and firefly being of light. So as the North Star rose, as day met night sky, butterfly fell in love with firefly.
Masila unne kadale
Conversations take years to finish.
War was born, war was born from rotting wounds left unhealed. Nobody's love.
Rushed from work with news of the burnings. Ignorant of the depth of government betrayal, the Colombo Tamil landlords thought if they put this young Jaffna family into riot-filled streets, they would be spared. Uncle and auntie ran to a neighbor only to be put out the next day. They secreted between buildings. When auntie's breasts emptied, they poured sugar into my baby cousin's mouth to mute his exposing cry. They wondered, how did the others escape? It was an elderly Sinhala man who hid my family in chicken coop by day and opened their home at night for them to sleep. He closed his ears to the calls of killings and his own son's demands to expel them. Instead, he evicted Veer.
We'll close out with one more piece, and we wanted to dedicate this to the young man, Jerome, who lost his life to unnecessary stabbing and violence this past weekend, and to all those who have inherited the sorrows
and who have been subjected at the mercy of the violence that we have yet to be able to heal and stop. On a hard day, sometimes I feel like we're losing ourselves. I feel like we're not growing anymore. I just want to creep inside myself and find that little girl, that little boy, that little child, and hold on to me. Not that I know why, I mean the world's always been messed up, right? And I've never known a time when there hasn't been trouble. And I've never known a time when there hasn't been war. And I've never known a time when our peoples weren't dying. So why do I want to be a kid again? It's just that when we were kids, we were always growing. Always getting taller, always getting bigger. The world could have been hollow, but we were full with creativity. Now I feel like I'm always getting smaller, trying to fit myself into that damn box. I need a time opener, releasing honeysuckle sips of innocence past. Y'all, we were all artists once, playing and dancing, painting the world with our imagination. Back then, little girls ran just as fast as little boys, climbing cheese high, collecting fuzzy caterpillars as we went. Fairies flew, saved me from the fights and blues, glittered smiles, petaled wings, sun-darkened blackberry juice, tamarind skins. We were anywhere and anything. If our whispered wishes, our thought out thoughts, our pitchless screams, our undreamt dreams, if they disappear, or do they ripple away from our ears past pain-polluted atmospheres and collect at the edges of space and time, where our poetry and rhyme gather with prayers and curses to expand the borders of the universes. Erase the borders of the universes, singing together our free verses. Will the universe get too big? Like tripped up thoughts in my head, like fading stars collapsing, pulling galaxies into themselves, sucking up my rippled dreams into giant black holes. Will the universe get too big? 'Cause sometimes I feel like things are too big and I am so confused. There are paths I am scared to follow. There are truths I am scared to swallow. And consumed by the fear of elimination, and whether it be through assassination or assimilation, we turn the guns onto ourselves, killing our inspiration. The sun and moon we let eclipse till voice and heart slip from our lips. Flips and twists, because our hands are the source of enemy rips. They turn ourselves upon ourselves. And through it all, Tamil blood keeps spilling. It's not about one woman, one man, or one child, one people, one war, one cause, or one strife. Say it, you feel it, about keeping us alive. Our peoples are dying, there's no rest for crying, and no one is trying to make things right. Y'all listen, y'all breathe, let heart beat and see, there's no liberation till all peoples are free. There's no liberation till colors are free, till sweat is set free, till breath is set free. There's no liberation till our dreams are set free, till dreams are set free.
Freedom.
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 Thank you.